the coral reef biome in the South China Sea. The undersea garden is full of different varieties, and they are at risk of disappearing. Chinese scientists have been monitoring the coral habitat. This is one of the laboratories they're pinning their hopes on.
这个是大概五年前我们这个通过有性繁育得到的个体，接近20公分左右一个大小。我们现在看的这些圆圆的小瓷片啊，就是我们上个月珊瑚产卵，通过有性繁殖得到的珊瑚的幼虫。能看到的话呢，这是浅黄色的这个小小的凸起，逐渐长成一个珊瑚个体。但是这个过程是非常漫长，长到一厘米大概需要一年左右。
Zhang Yuyang says coral reefs take up only 0.2% of the ocean floor, but they support up to one-third of all marine life. The fragile ecosystem is under threat from ocean warming, crown-of-thorn starfish, and human activities.
珊瑚礁它相当于是为周边的海域呢提供了一个产卵地、育幼场和觅食所这种功能。珊瑚礁一旦退化， 这些生物就数量急剧减少，珊瑚礁就是相当于对海洋生物多样性的一个重要的保障。那么一旦珊瑚礁生态系统消失了，就相当于将近1/3的海洋生物种呢失去了家园。In
April 2024, scientists from the International Coral Reef Initiative and the U.S. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration announced that the coral reefs around the world are experiencing a mass bleaching event that could become the worst of its kind in history. More than half of the world's coral reef areas experienced bleaching in 2023. Chinese scientists are growing coral in labs and in the open sea. Zhang Yang's institute began artificial coral cultivation in the South China Sea in 2009. It was also Zhang's first time to work in the Xisha Islands, also known as the Paracels. Over the past 15 years, Zhang has been monitoring the progress in all their testing areas. We first met Zhang Yuyang in 2014 at a coral breeding base in Sanya. At that time, he was waiting for the baby corals to grow. In 2016, we met him again. Those baby corals were transplanted just offshore the Xisha Islands.
珊瑚数量的慢慢的恢复，它可能需要的话呢，是10年甚至20年。A
more efficient option is what's called the nursery. Zhang Yuyang's team has been conducting experiments in the Xisha Islands. A key project was launched in 2017 in waters near Zhaoshu Island.
我们一只珊瑚呢，从大概8到10厘米左右大小，现在目前已经长成大概直径60到1米左右的一个珊瑚个体了。 那么珊瑚覆盖率呢，确实也是得到有效提升，从原来的不到10%增加到现在30%以上。我们当时选的是自米到10米深的一个区域进行了一个修复区，然后同时它离赵厝岛又比较近，便于我们进行监测和管护。我们修复区正好旁边挨着一大片沙地，我们可以用这片沙地呢用来去做培育珊瑚的苗圃。 那么呢，在水底下呢，直接建好苗圃架以后，把珊瑚断枝放在上面，等它珊瑚断枝长成小的珊瑚个体，再移植到旁边的珊瑚礁上。目前的话，珊瑚生长到已经性成熟了，它自主的产生珊瑚的卵子和精子进行繁育，向四周扩散，带动周边珊瑚的话恢复。
Another successful case by Zhang Yuyang's team is at Wuzhizhou Island in southern China's Hainan province. Coral area has doubled since 2016, with more than 50,000 corals transplanted. Planting coral has brought economic benefits for the locals. Wuzhizhou has become a diving resort. Zhang Yuyang showed us the underwater pictures he took. These are the fragments transplanted in 2017. Now many corals are the size of a table.
当时这一片的珊瑚的话呢，较以前退化了不少。然后我们呢就利用这个珊瑚的断枝呢，就直接在水底下进行遗体。生态变好以后，我们发现这个鱼类数量增多，珊瑚礁的功能也逐渐恢复。它不但是提供这种游客的观赏， 那么呢，像对保护海岸呢，就防止海浪和台风对海岸的一个侵袭，也起到一个很有效的作用。
Professor Zhang Yuyang emphasizes the interconnectedness of the South China Sea's ecosystem. China can't do it alone, but that won't stop him from trying to green the blue.
我个人梦想的话呢，就是让我们国家的珊瑚礁恢复到更好的水平，那么我们的子孙后代呢，仍然能够有机会去欣赏这个美丽富饶的生态系统，而不是说以后只能从书本上或影片上见到珊瑚礁，然后呢，告诉后代说我们曾经有这么漂亮的一片生机勃勃的水下生态系统，但是现在却看不到了。